So in radix two decimation in frequency algorithm, okay, the frequency domain sequence x of k is going to be decimated. Okay, so therefore in this algorithm also the same process will be followed. That is n point time domain sequence will be first converted into n by 2 point sequences. Again n by 2 point sequences are further decimated into n by 4 point sequences. Okay, so till we are reaching the 2 point sequences. Okay, so finally our intention is to get 2 point and sequence for which 2 point DFT is computed. Okay, but here the only difference with the DIT algorithm is you are doing the decimation with respect to x of k sequence rather than x of n. That's why the algorithm is called as decimation in frequency algorithm. So why it is radix 2? Because again we are decimating till we get 2 point sequences. That's why it is called radix 2 algorithms. Okay, so now in this some notations are used here, like as x of k is decimated into two sequences. So we know x of k is a n point sequence. Okay, so therefore when it is decimated into two numbers, their length will be n by 2. Okay, n by 2 point sequence. So now we are going to call those two n by 2 point sequences as g1 of k and g2 of k. That is g1 of k and g2 of k, they are also what, frequency domain sequences only, but they are half of x of k. Okay, so like g1 of k may represent the even numbered sequence, g2 of k is a odd numbered sequence. That is g1 of k is composed of even numbered samples of x of k, whereas g2 of k is formed by odd samples of x of k. So therefore now let us see what is this algorithm and how to get the DFT sample, that is endpoint DFT calculation, using the DIF algorithm. Okay, so therefore coming to this derivation part, again we are going to start with the x of k equation, and we know that the endpoint DFT equation is given by x of k equal to summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n. So this is the as usual equation. Okay, now here the representation is slightly modified because we need to show the decimation on x of k. Okay, so therefore x of n, x of k is equivalently represented like this. What is this equivalent representation? Just look at the summations. So here summation n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, that is half of n, okay, plus again the remaining half will start at n equal to n by 2, because here it has closed at n by 2 minus 1. Okay, now it will start at exactly n by 2, therefore the last point will be n minus 1. Suppose if n is equal to 8, then what is this summation, n equal to 0 to 3, and this summation will start from 4 to 7, 4 to 7. Okay, so therefore it is split into two parts. Okay, so this is the first step in decimating the x of k. Okay, so therefore now continuing the same thing, so x of k equal to n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, so x of k n w raised to k n, this will remain same. But here you just observe, instead of taking this as a limit, because the other half is also a 4 point sequence only. Okay, so n equal to n by 2 to n minus 1 is also half sequence only. Okay, or a half part of the x of k. Okay, so therefore here some change is made with respect to the summation limits. So as length of these two sections are same, okay, so here it is also changed as n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, but here internally with this n you are adding n plus n by 2 w raised to k, so n will be changed as n plus n by 2. Okay, so this is because you are considering four samples here in the first part and remaining four samples here. So in order to locate their locations, okay, so we need n plus n by 2 and here n plus n by 2. So therefore, summation n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1, this part is not going to change. Now here, with respect to this Trudel factor, so we need some simplification. So first part will be kn, the next part will be just multiply k into n by 2. So there is kn by 2. Now we will write what is the equivalent value of this w raised to kn by 2. So therefore, the phase term w raised to kn by 2. So simplify this, because we know w is e to the power of minus j 2 pi by n. Okay, so then kn by 2 will get multiplied with this n to the power, and then simplification will give you minus 1 whole raised to k. Therefore, now we will substitute the reduced value in the above equation. Okay. See here. So whatever this w raised to k and second part of the Trudel factor is there, its value comes to be minus 1 whole raised to k. So therefore, minus 1 whole raised to k into this. So therefore, you can take out or you can write it outside the bracket. Okay, and remaining terms here. So in the remaining term, you are going to get only w raised to kn with the suffix n. So now we observe this w Trudel factor as a common between the two parts. Therefore, in the next step, it is a simplification. Simplification in the sense, you are simply taking out the w raised to kn term as a common factor. That's all. So therefore, x of k is now finally equal to, so summation n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1. So okay, x of n plus, and this part minus 1 raised to k. Minus 1 raised to k x of n plus n by 2. Okay. So this summation will be same, because n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Here also n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1 only. So therefore, the overall representation of x of k has been changed from its basic form to as shown in equation 1. So now hence onwards, this is our reference equation. Okay, so x of k, it is an alternate representation for our DFT. Okay, so now why it is represented is because it is going to further help in us showing the decimation. Okay, so in decimation, what is our principle is, okay, so half part is composed of the even samples and remaining half is odd samples. Therefore, if we represent x of k in this particular format, so easily it can be split into two sections, that is even and the odd samples. So therefore, equation 1 is a now the new x of k equation. Now the further work, okay, is carried out on the new equation of x of k, that is represented by equation 1. Okay, so therefore let us split x of k into even and odd numbered samples. So now in this you can show even and odd numbered samples. So we need to only manipulate with the k value, that's all. Okay, see here, because on the LHS what we have x of k. So k value 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 7 we have. In that we have to choose even and the odd. So therefore for even values of k, x of k will become x of 2k. Okay, so x of k will become x of 2k. Now apply this 2k. Okay, everywhere on the RHS. So x of n plus minus 1 raised to, instead of k, now you put 2k. Here also, instead of k, put 2k in the Trudel factor. So now minus 1 raised to 2k will always be a positive number. Therefore, x of 2k is finally equal to, okay, x of n plus n by 2. Have only, now here in the Trudel factor also, so it is taken back into the standard form. Okay. So only kn is retained. Kn is retained and n is changed as n by 2. W raised to kn n by 2. So now this x of 2k is representing what it is now. It is only the even numbered samples. So in the entire X of K, so there are four even numbered samples and four odd numbered samples if n is equal to 8. Okay, so therefore as it is X of 2k, here you can check that k value should also be limited between 0 to n by 2 minus 1 only. Okay, suppose if n is equal to 8, then this value will be 0, 1, 2, 3. So k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 are the four even numbered samples. Even numbered samples. Then similarly, for odd numbered samples, okay, what is there in the odd numbered samples? Now in the same equation, okay, so put x of 2k plus 1, that's all. Okay, you just observe the equation 1. So in equation 1, what we have x of k. Okay, so to write even numbered, we have written 2k. Now for the odd number, just replace it by 2k plus 1. And the same 2k plus 1, you need to substitute everywhere, wherever k is there in equation 1. So it is 2k plus 1. And similarly here also, 12 factor is also raised to 2k plus 1 into n. And now this minus 1 raised to 2k plus 1, that is odd number, is always a minus 1 only. So therefore now we will start getting the difference. So on the LHS, it is always x of 2k plus 1, that is equal to, now the length will be half only, n by 2 minus 1. But here it is the difference between the two samples, that is x of n minus, because this minus 1 raised to 2k plus 1 is always going to give us minus 1. Okay, now minus x n plus n by 2. Now simplifying this 12 factor, it has two parts now. One is w raised to n part, other one is w raised to 2kn. W raised to 2kn, even in the previous equation 2 also, we got the same phase term, and we have simplified it as w raised to kn suffix n by 2. So here also same, we will put it in the suffix n by 2, retaining w raised to n as it is, because nothing can be done with that. Okay, so therefore it is simply like a constant, a w raised to n with the suffix capital N, suffix capital N, and that is retained as it is. So therefore now you can see that whenever you are writing for odd number, that is whenever the decimation is for the odd numbered sample, okay, what is the standard format that is there for x of k sequences, x of 2k plus 1 equal to, observe the length here, in the summation it is 0 to n by 2 minus 1, but now it is the difference, x of n minus x of n plus n by 2, and also the difference will be multiplied by, okay, now the difference will be multiplied by w raised to n small n, that will be into w raised to kn n by 2, and again k is evaluated for 4 values, k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, or in general 0, 1 up to n by 2 minus 1. So therefore now equation 3 is a standard equation to show the another decimated sequence which is composed of all odd samples. So now you just take a glance at equation 2 and equation 3's. Equation 2 and 3's. So equation 2 represents the even numbered samples. You can just observe here summation is 0 to n by 2 minus 1 only. Here also summation is 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Now this is addition, x of n plus n by 2. But here it is, in equation 3 it is x of n minus x of n plus n by 2. Next in equation 2, the sum is multiplied by w raised to kn n by 2. But here the difference is multiplied by two terms, w raised to n and w raised to kn n by 2. Okay, so these are the two decimated sequences that are obtained out of x of k. We started with x of k, and that is equation 1. Okay, just to go back here, so you can see here, x of k is equation 1. We started with this. This is a basic equation. This is decimated. We are not decimating x of n here. We are decimating x of k. Okay, so that's why we are arriving at x of 2k as well as x of 2k plus 1. Okay, so therefore 2 and 3 are the two decimated sequences of x of k. So now to make it simple, because further the decimation is going to continue. So if we retain the same equations, okay, so the representation becomes tedious or complicated. Therefore, in order to make it simple, let us identify x of 2k and x of 2k plus 1 by a separate notation, because they are also DFT samples only now. Okay, so they are also DFT sequences only. So therefore, let us change their namings. Similarly, on the RHS, coming to the RHS, okay, so whatever addition and subtraction we have here, so they are representing new time domain sequence for us, because whenever x of n is added with x of n plus n by 2, a new time domain sample is originated. Similarly, here also, whenever we are taking a difference between the two samples in the time domain, whatever the resulting answer is there, that is also the time domain only, time domain sample only. Okay, so therefore now the next part will be to rename the addition and subtraction equations in 2 and 3, as well as this x of 2k and x of 2k plus 1. Okay, so therefore, let us now define the two time domain sequences g1 of n and g2 of n. Okay, so they both consist of how many samples? N by 2 samples, because once they are decimated, they should contain n by 2 samples only. Therefore, what is this g1 of n now? G1 of n is going to represent now onwards the addition part, that is x of n plus x of n plus n by 2. So therefore, in equation 2, I'm just displaying this equation 2. So wherever I have this addition, x of n plus x of n plus n by 2, so this will be replaced by the term g1. Similarly, in equation 3, wherever we have x of n minus x of n plus n by 2, that will be replaced by another time domain sequence g2 of n. Okay, once we name these two as g1 and g2, correspondingly on the LHS also, we will call x of 2k as capital g1 of k and x of 2k plus 1 as capital g2 of k. Okay, so therefore here it is given clearly, let g1 of n is equal to addition, that is x of n plus x of n plus n by 2. Similarly, g2 of n is also x of n minus, now it is minus x of n plus n by 2, but along with that, this should be observed, w raised to n is there, w raised to n, because it doesn't contain k term. Okay, we cannot take w raised to kn here, kn is not our time domain sequence. Okay, so therefore, along with the difference, this w raised to n is also will be included. And same, the range of the n values will be same, n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n by 2, minus 1, n by 2, minus 1 for both. Okay, so therefore now we will consolidate, and at the same time, let x of 2k be called as g1 of k, x of 2k plus 1 be called as g2 of k. So these are the new namings. Okay, so now we will substitute all these new names, that is g1 of k, g2 of k, g1 of n, g2 of n in the above equations. And finally, equation 3, 2 and 3, they are now modified like this. Okay, so wherever x of 2k is there, I am calling it as g1 of k. So g1 of k equal to summation, this will not change, n equal to 0 to n by 2 minus only it is. Okay, so therefore, now you just observe only the, the time domain part, that is g1 of n into w raised to kn n by 2. Now, once it is a decimated sequence, obviously, total factor should contain n by 2 only. And as it is k, okay, so DFT sequence it is, we will always write k, the range of k. So, it is 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Similarly, g2 of k, what is g2 of k? It is going to represent x of 2k plus 1, that is all odd numbered samples. Therefore, g2 of k, its corresponding time domain sequence is g2 of n, okay, that into w raised to k, same. Okay, so both sequences are identical, except, okay, so g1 is even number, g2 is odd number, that's all. So now you can observe gradually that we have arrived at equation 7 and 8, so which are actually what, the decimated parts of x of k. Okay, so x of k is split into now two parts, g1 of k and g2 of k. So this is what is first stage decimation. So where g1 of k representing all even numbered samples, where g2 of k representing all odd numbered samples. That's why the algorithm is named as decimation in frequency. Decimation in frequency, because DFT sequence, which is in frequency domain, is decimated. Okay, so therefore now whatever this g1 of k and g2 of k are there, now they are viewed as individual sequences now. Okay, so because further decimation has to proceed. Okay, so how long it has to proceed? Till we reach our 2-point radix or 2-to-point DFTs. Okay, so therefore we will move on to the next stage, where we are going to further decimate g1 of k and g2 of k individually. Now whatever the treatment that we have done with the x of k, the same thing will be done with the g1 of k and g2 of k symmetrically. Yes. Okay, so what we did with x of k, whatever the procedure we followed for x of k, the same procedure, same representation, everything will be done with g1 of k and g2 of k individually. Only thing is, now their lengths are half. Earlier x of k, it was n point sequence. Now g1, g2, they are n by 2 point sequences, that's all. Okay, so again, for in g1 of k, g1 of n represents the time domain sequence. This can be further decimated. Similarly, for g2 of k, okay, so the g2 of n is the sequence and g2 of k is also further decimated. Okay, so therefore now, once g1, g2 undergo decimation, it is going to yield what? Totally 4 sequences, because 2 sequences from g1 and another 2 sequences from g2. So totally we are going to get now 4 new 2-point sequences, suppose n is equal to 2. So if n is equal to 8, sorry, if n is equal to 8, okay, so we are going to get 2-point sequence. So generally speaking, when g1 of k is decimated, okay, whatever the 2 new sequences it gives, their lengths will be n by 4 or 0 to n by 4 minus 1 will be the length. So therefore now let us do the same procedure with g1 and g2. What is that procedure? Writing even part and the odd part. So therefore now, as only length is the criterion here, okay, so therefore we can directly come up with the equations of g1. Okay, so therefore g1 of k, it is now written as the addition of 2 parts. Okay, and what are the 2 parts? G1 of n w raised to k n n by 2. Okay, why it is n by 2? Because we are dealing with the half length sequence, 4-point sequence. Okay, now you observe the summation, the range is 0 to n by 4 minus 1. Okay, still it is reduced to half. Okay, first of all, g1 of k length is n by 2. This is again reduced to half, therefore it will be n by 4. So summation starting from 0 to n by 4 minus 1. Similarly here also. Now it is actually n by 4 to n by 2 minus 1. But in the next step, okay, so we are changing it to 0 to n by 4 minus 1 only. But the change is made with respect to the index here. Okay, so by changing the indices, so the same thing we followed with even x of k also. Okay, so therefore now the summation carries the same index, n equal to 0 to n by 4 minus 1, n by 4 minus 1. Now it is g1 of n, now it is g1 of n plus n by 4. But while doing with x of k, it was n plus n by 2, now it is n by 4. Okay, so therefore throughout this derivation, you can observe that how the length of the sequences are being reduced or decimated. And even the Tweddle factor also, obviously n by 2. But here, you just observe, it is now n plus n by 4. Now in the next step, same, you will have to split this into 2 parts. So now this w raised to kn n by 2, w raised to kn by 4 n by 2. Okay, so we need to simplify these 2 terms individually, and after simplification, whatever this kn by 4 n by 2 term is there, okay, so you can just observe here, simplification is done, e power minus j 2 pi by n by 2 into kn by 4. Okay, whatever the common terms are there, you just cancel them, and it is going to yield minus 1 raised to k, the same the result as we obtained in the stage 1 also. Now this minus 1 raised to k, substitute here, and this w raised to k in n by 2, it will be retained as it is. Now you can just observe, with this summation also we have w raised to k in n by 2. In this also obviously it should come, but whatever this minus 1 raised to k is there, it is put outside the bracket. And remaining the summation, everything is same. So therefore, we will write a consolidated a representation for g1 of k. Therefore, g1 of k is, what is this, 0 to n by 4 minus 1. G1 of n plus minus 1 raised to k, g1 of n plus n by 4. So now this is actually what it is. It is an alternate or equivalent representation for g1 of k, which is actually what, a part of x of k. Okay, now similarly, following the same line, g2 of k also, no changes with the g2, except you have to write the sequence, time domain sequences, g2 of n everywhere. Remaining all twiddle factor, their length, everything is going to remain same. Now once we are ready with the representation, first part, first step will be the representation. Next it is a decimation. Okay, so therefore next the decimation of g1 and g2 will start. Now in the decimation, we are going to apply 2k and 2k plus 1. Now the same step is done even with the x of k also. First we have represented x of k. Okay, so later on we have converted as x of 2k and 2k plus 1. Similarly here also, first we are writing g1 of k, g2 of k. Now what we are taking out, even values as well as the odd values. So therefore g1 of 2k, that is even numbered samples of g1 of k, that is equal to summation of n equal to 0 to n by 4 minus 1. So same thing. Okay, now only the time domain sequence you will have to write g1 of n, that's all, and this will not change. Minus 1 raised to 2k will be there always. So but here coming to this twiddle factor, the length will be here n by 2. Okay, so then minus 1 raised to 2k, it is going to give you plus 1. So therefore g1 of 2k, it represents what, the addition between the two time domain samples. Similarly, when you go for the odd values, you will put g1 of 2k plus 1. So when you put 2k plus 1, so here after simplification you are going to get minus, that is the difference between g1 values. And you can observe that here the lengths will be up to n by 4 minus 1 only. Okay, so g1 of 2k and g1 of 2k plus 1, they are the decimated sequences of g1 of k. And similarly following the same procedure, you can write directly for g2. So g2 also, obviously g2 plus g2 of n plus n by 4, and g2 of 2k plus 1, g2 minus g2 n plus n by 4. So once you write for x of k, so then for writing the next decimations, it is only a sign, it is only a sequence change, length change, that's all. Okay, so therefore now we have what, come up with the four different equations, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, so g1 part, that is even and odd equations of g1, even and odd equations of g2. Now once we arrive at this, what is the next step is, we will allot, okay, some new notations. Like we will identify these sequences by a simpler terms, like we done with the previous things. Okay, so now let us define the two new time sequences. Okay, so now you can observe here, for g1 we have what, g1 of 2k and g1 of 2k plus 1. Okay, so therefore g1 of n plus g1 of n plus n by 4. So this is another time domain sequence. Okay, now we will replace this everything with a simple time domain representation, like d1 1 of n. Similarly for odd sequence also, we will replace this sequence name. And as we are changing them on the LHS also, instead of calling it as g1 of 2k, 2k plus 1, we will put a simple name. Okay, like d1 d11 and d12. Okay, so therefore the same thing will be done even for the g2 of also. So even with the g2 of k also, instead of keeping the complex equations everywhere, you can replace them, and the subtraction and addition. Okay, so they can be, they are another sequences only, they are new time domain sequence only. So therefore totally we are going to come up with the 2, 4 time domain sequences. All lengths are n by 4 only. Okay, so their names are d1 1 of n, d1 2 of n. See, now you just observe the suffix here, d1 1, d1 2. Okay, so therefore here the first number 1 1 in these two represents that they are coming from g1 of k. Okay, in that, okay, the second number 1 represents even part, 2 represents the odd part. Similarly, d21 and d22, okay, the first suffix 2 represents, they are related with the g2 of k, they are related to g2 of k, and the last second suffix 1 and 2, they represent even and the odd parts. Okay, so therefore so here the sequences are again written also. Just go through, what is d1? D1 is simply g1 of n plus g1 of n plus n by 4. But whereas d1 of 2 is, it is a difference multiplied by w raised to n n by 2. Okay, because for a difference or for an odd sequence, this is common. Similarly, d21 and d22, plus and minus, minus sequence multiplied by Trudel pact. Okay, therefore, once you define the sequences on the LHS also, instead of writing their names as g1 of 2k, 2k plus 1, we will call them by some different DFT names, like d11 of k and d12 of k. So here also you observe capital D's. Capital letters here are representing the DFT samples. Okay? So the first number d11, it is again the same thing. It has come from, or it is a part of g1. Okay, so d11 of k and d12 of k, they represent the decimated sequences of what? g1 of k. So whereas d21 of k and d22 of k, they represent what? The decimated sequences of g2 of k. Okay, so therefore now in equation 14, 15, 16, 17, they are just the replacements, that's all. Okay, now g1 of 2k, it is nothing but, it can be written as d11 of k simply, and that is equal to, so d11 of n. Now you just observe d11 of k, you have d11 of n. Similarly, d12 of k, which is a DFT, which is what? DFT of d12 of n. d21 of k, it is a DFT of d21 of n sequence. Similarly, the last one. Okay. So now, if n is equal to 8, okay, if n is equal to 8, then 14, 15, 16, 17 equations, they represent now 2-point DFTs. And even our decimation will stop here. Okay, so if it is not 8-point, okay, if it is 16-point, then one more stage will continue. Okay, so let us assume that we were doing for this n equal to 8 only. So therefore now, this is the last stage, decimation. Okay, so these are the last equations. Now, one thing you observe here, what is the number of points of DFTs? It is 0 to n by 4 minus 1. It is a n by 4 point DFTs. So, all capital D's are n by 4 point DFTs. All capital G, that is G1 and G2, they are n by 2 point DFTs. And obviously, X of K is the 8 n point DFT. Okay. So, therefore, the decimation frequency can be continued till we obtain 2-point DFTs. Okay? So, as I told you, if you assume that this is n is equal to 8, then the D stage, that is this stage, will be the last stage. So, therefore, throughout the equation, okay, so we started with what? X of k actually. X of k going back. So X of k as represented in equation 1, X of k was decimated into two parts. What are those? X of 2k and X of 2k plus 1. They are further named as g1 of k and g2 of k. So therefore, you can imagine that X of k branches into two segments, g1 and g2. So again, g1, g2, they are treated as individual DFT sequences. And g1 of k is decimated into d1, 1 of k. And d1 2 of k. Similarly, g2 of k is another DFT sequence which is again decimated into two parts, that is d2 1 of k and d2 2 of k. So like this, in every stage the frequency domain sequence is decimated. Okay, that's why the algorithm is known as radix 2 decimation in frequency algorithm.